Children, we have understood from this map the importance of the direction. After understanding the direction, it is very important to understand the few concepts of geography which we commonly use. We represent the certain countries with the help of latitudes and longitudes. What are we understand by the meaning of latitude and longitude? Can you see this on the in the picture? This is the earth, and on which the semicircular lines, and these are the lines which represent the latitudes and longitudes. You can go back to the page on the 7. You can see on the globe, this is covered by the latitudes and longitudes on the globe. This covering of the latitudes and longitudes, have they drawn by me? Have they drawn by any of the geographer or the scientist? They are all imaginary line for understanding the map or for understanding the places easily. Like how our houses has got number. If somebody comes to SV Union, we say you have to go to the 414 Somwarpet. 414 Somwarpet, he will reach to the SV Union High School and Junior College. He will not go to the SV Union Primary School because we have certain number. Even these latitudes and longitudes, which are the horizontal and vertical line, have certain number. With the help of these number, suppose there are children sitting, or 50 children are sitting in the class. I want to call out certain child and I don't know the name of the child. I'll say the child started on the third bench in the middle row with the greenhouse. I will say the third bench in the middle row. It means the child understand, and then I am giving an additional qualification. The child is wearing a green color uniform or is from the greenhouse. So these are all add the qualities of certain the place which we are describing. So these locations are reflected with the help of latitudes and longitudes. For you to understand, we know that we have talked about our own country. If somebody asks me to find out the country, you will first find out your own country, because with which we are familiar. We see that India is located over here. It is located in the northeastern hemisphere of the world. The latitudinal and the longitudinal extent of India. This is longitudinal extent and this is latitudinal extent of India. 8 degrees 4 minutes north to 37 degrees north and 68 degrees to 97 degrees east. This is the longitudinal extent. Now we have to understand these latitudes and longitudes. To understand these latitudes and longitudes, please refer to the board. There are horizontal lines, we call them as in parallels of latitude, and these vertical lines are called as in meridians of longitude. They are very important part in geography which describes the location of the place. These latitudes and the longitude will help us to identify where the place is located. Now you can open your book, the page number 10 in the lesson number 2. There is a world map which is being shown. In this world map, these parallel lines indicates the latitude and these vertical lines or the semicircular lines which indicate longitude. This is the globe, and on this globe we also can identify these latitudes and longitudes, which are the semicircular lines. The distance which we have already studied about, the north-south distance on the globe, this is North Pole and this is South Pole. This is North Pole and the South Pole. It covers a distance of 12,714 kilometers. And the east and the west, east and the west distance is 12,756 kilometers. It's very important for us to identify what are the parallels of latitude and how I can draw these parallels of latitude on the globe. Are they drawn? They are imaginary lines. If we assume the earth is round, which is flattened at the poles, and it had got a bulge at the equator. We know that the longest chord in the circle passes through the center of the circle is the longest chord. The line in the center of the equator, which passes through the center, we call it as an equator. The line which passes through the center of the earth is called as an equator. Now this line which divides the earth into two parts. You can see on the globe, this is the part which is the northern and this is the southern part. We have described the earth, it is round in shape and flattened at pole. It is not straight, it has got a tilted axis and this axis is tilted at 23 and a half degrees the axis is tilted. Now we have to draw these lines on the circle. These lines of the circle, we see that these parallel lines are called as an latitude. These parallel lines are called as an latitude, parallels of the latitude. Are this any of the parallel lines can meet anywhere? If these lines are parallel, they do not meet at any place. And therefore, these latitudes are called as an parallels. The distance between two latitudes is 111 kilometer. The distance between two parallels of latitudes is 111 kilometer, and these lines do not meet. They run in east-west direction. The line, the most important line, we call this as a parallel of latitude. The 0 degree is called as an equator. And in the longitude 0 degrees meridian, it is called as a prime meridian. Now, these lines help us to identify certain more important location of the places. When we are learning about the places, it explains certain locations of the places. Now, this is the earth which is get divided into two parts. This line 0 divides a part as a northern hemisphere and a part is in southern hemisphere. This is north and this is south. We can see that this is the circle. This line divides part, one part and another part. The part which lies in the north is called as the northern hemisphere. The part which lies is in the south is called as the southern hemisphere. This is the north-south. The 0 degrees latitude. This is called the line of equator and this is the longest chord on the earth. Whereas the another chord which we are going to study about, the line which is a straight line, which is the 0 degrees longitude or the meridians of longitude, we have called it as a prime meridian. Prime meridian also divides the earth into two parts. The part to this called as an eastern hemisphere, part to this is called as a western hemisphere. This part lies to the east of the prime meridian is called as an eastern hemisphere. The part west lies to the western hemisphere. Now, eastern and the western hemisphere is helper to identify certain locations. Suppose if I am talking about my own country, I say India is located in the northeastern hemisphere. So I say this is north and this is the northeastern hemisphere India is located. If I want to draw, show India over here, I can show somewhere over here that India is located. The map on the globe, it is located in the northeastern hemisphere. A country which is commonly used today we criticize because of that. We all are learning with this new method of teaching is the COVID. You know where the COVID originated? COVID originated in China. So find out where is China which is located. The China is located to the east of India. toward the east of India. It is located again in the northeastern hemisphere of India. It is located in the northeastern hemisphere, but it is located above India. It is located above India is very important for us to identify. We have studied the place where the Wuhan is located. It is on the eastern margins of China. If I want to look at the map of India, we know that this is part of India with which we all are familiar. We see that India is located in the northeastern hemisphere. India is located in the northeastern hemisphere. Can you refer to this map, world map? If I'm locating in this map, or there are so many world maps. Okay. This is the map, world map, represent India politically. Now this is India, which is located in the northeastern hemisphere, where I'm talking about Australia, which is located in the southeastern hemisphere. I'm talking about a country called Brazil, which is located in the southwestern hemisphere. The Brazil is located in the USA, or USA is, or we commonly call it as an America, is located in the northwestern hemisphere. This is 0 degrees longitude, which divides the earth into eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. This is northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. It is very important distinction that we have to know about it, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Now another important concept which we have learned today is about drawing of latitudes and longitude. Why they are important? The latitudes and longitude tells us about the different places, where the places are being located in the world with reference to this. Suppose if my number is in 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and if these places are number 5, 10, 50, 20. Now, if I want to know where the place is located, I'll say that if the place is located over here, I'll say that the place is located at 20 degrees. We are writing here 20 degrees east and 10 degrees northern latitude the place is located. Location of India we have learned, location of China we have learned, location of USA we have learned, and that is why it is very important to identify the location of the place.